approach. You cannot stop looking at either. One second. Beautiful painting, you cannot stop looking at. Seats and the new entertainment system. Manny Cospin did a great job specifying it. It's a mix between 100 and 1-to-1, I would say. I get 100 and 1-to-1. So, as the 200, has it gold underneath? No, not there. It looks quite clean without model designation.
Thank you.
skuggan.
Ja, ser du den flygande?
Ja, och vart kommer du ifrån? See the ghost. Ja, där ja. Ja, yeah, see the ghost. Vad snyggt du är. From the fighter squad.
Interesting news to share with you, and maybe I would like to start axle is adjustable in right height, each corner individually. The bump and rebound is adjustable on each shock absorber individually, depending on which mode you're in and which speed you're going at. Underneath the front bumper, we have adjustable clamps for aero control at high speed, and the world's first top-mounted, fully foldable active rear wing. I think many of you know already, and I'll explain more extreme type of torque converter, which can take a combined 1,600-1,700 newton meters of torque from the electric motor and the combustion engine. It also has a lockup functionality, so that when you kind of get up to 30, 35 kilometers per hour, you can lock that up, and then you have an engine RPM of around 1,000 RPM. As we don't have any gearbox, how do we reverse? Well, we have these two big electrical motors on the side of the differential. That gives us torque vectoring. That gives us another 800 newton meter per wheel direct drive. That sounds more than it is because there's no gearing to gear it down to give more torque. Still a lot. And it gives us reverse. We can even reverse when this is running, kind of wanting to pull the car forward and torque forward, we can still reverse when it's going backwards. And of course it gives us that extra push from takeoff and instant acceleration when you're driving. So to put this into context, if we only use these rear electrical motors from a standstill acceleration, 0 to 100 is just over 4 seconds with only these two. Combustion engine and the torque converter without these two is about 4 to 4.5 seconds to 100 with no electrical support. And together, we're of course traction limited, so it depends on your tire, your grip, your track, how you heat the tires and so on. But on a good day, you can do 2.7, 2.8 seconds on constant slip level as it's on the rear wheel drive. That's a very, very good number, but in today's world, it's becoming a very normal number. Even in a five-seater Tesla. But what is not the normal number is that the car can do 0 to 400 in just around 20 seconds. Our aim is to go under 20 seconds, 400 kilometers per hour. That's really where the car shows its difference. From 100 to 200, 200 to 300, 300 to 400, it's just a rocket ship. But given that we have torque vectoring back here, we do traction controlling directly with the electrical motors on the drive shafts with no delay of any combustion engine and so on. You can stay on the slip limit very safely and very stably up to top speed almost. The car does just over 400 or just over 250 kilometers per hour before we hit the rev limiter, as we don't have any more gears. But as we say at Koenigsegg, it's not who has the ultimate fastest car, which you hardly can use because there are no roads in the world to give you that opportunity. What we say, whoever gets to 400 first or 250 miles per hour first wins. And we think we have that game made. We can talk a little bit about the battery pack here as well. This is a very, very extreme battery pack. It's only 4.5 kilowatt hours, which is quite small. We used to actually start out in the first prototype with a 7 or 8 kilowatt hour battery pack. But we noticed we didn't need the volume of energy or the amount for kilowatt hours. We needed the possibility to drain a lot of kilowatts quickly. So this is the smallest, lightest size and the smallest kilowatt hours that we could package to drain 500 kilowatts of power. This, including its liquid cooling system, weighs 66 kilos, and we can drain 500 kilowatts of power momentarily. For those of you who know this type of technology, we're talking 120C discharge and 70-75C charge. These are unheard of numbers in any production car. This is what you find in a Formula One
congratulations, Christian.
Oh, thank you.
You're live and on YouTube and everything.
Thank you.